In this video, we'll be taking a look at the 10W version of the ComMarker Omni. This is a highly capable UV laser that can engrave nearly all types of materials, something no other laser type can achieve. Now, you might remember that I reviewed the 5W version before. This 10W model is basically its bigger and more powerful sibling. Here I need to mention that everything that I previously engraved with the 5W version can also be done with the 10W machine. That's why I won't repeat the same information. Instead, I'll focus primarily on the tasks where the 10W model performs significantly better than the 5W. But you should definitely watch the original video. I will leave a link in the video description. The main difference between the two models is that the 5W machine is air-cooled and the 10W version is water-cooled. The cooling system consists of a separate chiller unit that connects to the laser source via a set of hoses. The chiller includes a compressor and a radiator and functions similarly to a refrigerator, maintaining a stable water temperature. It has a cooling capacity of 420 watts and can either heat or cool the water depending on the ambient conditions. I appreciate that it runs fairly quietly, which is a big plus. It's also compact enough to fit neatly on the laser bed, making it convenient for both storage and portability, something I really like. Physically, the 10W unit has slightly less depth than the 5W version, but otherwise the construction is very similar, aside from the 5W model being air-cooled and this one being liquid-cooled. Another key difference is that the 10W version features a smaller galvo head enclosed in a metal casing, whereas the 5W model uses a plastic cover. Additionally, the 10W machine uses a physically smaller lens size, meaning the lenses are not interchangeable between the two models. Both machines, however, come with lenses that share the same optical parameters, one for a 150mm working area and one for a 70mm working area. In this video, I'll be using the 150mm lens for all demonstrations unless I specifically mention switching to the 70mm lens. But first, a quick disclaimer. My machine is a prototype unit, and it originally had the Z-axis column mounted on the opposite side due to using a different base plate. As a result, the laser head was not positioned in the center of the machine. However, I received the correct Z-axis plate midway through recording this video, so you may notice both configurations appearing throughout. When I removed the base plate, I found that the internal electronics were neatly organized, featuring off-the-shelf power supplies and modules. This design should make repairs straightforward in case anything ever fails. First, I adjusted the frequency range of the machine, which, according to the manual, can operate from 20 to 150 kHz. It's important to note that the higher the frequency, the lower the maximum pulse width you can set. This effect was clearly visible when I engraved a test pattern on raw aluminum. At higher frequencies, there was little to no effect at larger Q pulse settings. Overall, the engravings looked great. Some settings produced dark, deep engravings, while others created shallow, bright white marks. I also did a quick test on anodized aluminum, and I was easily able to make perfect white engravings at many different parameters, which means that this laser has a lot of power available. I also tried a cross-hatching mode, and the result was even better. Next, I tested how well the ComMarker Omni performs at engraving plywood. I engraved a simple test pattern, which varies the frequency and the Q pulse width, which is in my opinion the best test pattern for UV lasers. It appears that the 40 to 60 kHz frequency range delivers the deepest engravings. At higher frequencies, the engraved areas become smoother, which is visually appealing, especially for deep engraving work. One feature I didn't explore enough with the 5W version was its ability to cut wood with exceptional precision and zero burn marks. The 10W ComMarker Omni has enough power to cut through plywood quickly and cleanly, no need for wobble parameters, resulting in incredibly thin, precise cuts. The edges have zero burn marks, and the cutting kerf is so small that the part has an interference fit when it is placed back in the cutout. For the ultimate test, I cut an intricate art piece from 2mm thick plywood. It was mesmerizing to watch the machine performing fast and clean cuts in near silence. Once completed, the part simply popped out, leaving behind a beautifully detailed piece of art. I'm still amazed at the level of clarity and precision this UV laser can achieve. Thanks to its razor-sharp cutting ability, this machine is perfect for creating wood inlays. By cutting the same shape from two different wood types and swapping them, the fit is seamless. Then, I tried a different type of inlay. I created a quick design using Kittle.com to make it look as a proper end product. Kittle is the best tool to make professional-looking designs as a non-designer like me. You should check it out. I will leave a link in the video description. I had a batch of pearl discs and was surprised by how well the ComMarker Omni cut through them. The cuts were clean and the corners crisp. After inserting the inlay into the wood, the result was fantastic. This method is perfect for making pearl inlays for guitars or other instruments. One of the most practical things you can do to make your life easier is to create a focusing stick, which makes it much easier to consistently focus the machine on different objects. The stick ensures the correct distance between the lens frame and the material surface so that the engraving effect is the strongest. I engraved a set of lines on an angled aluminum business card. The engraving effect is the strongest where the shiny metal can be seen below the black paint. The middle of it is exactly the point where the optimal focus is. While we are at it, I swapped the 150mm lens with the 70mm, which provides much smaller focus spot and stronger engraving effect, but has much shorter focus distance and much narrower focus range. I engraved the same set of lines on an angled aluminum business card, and we can clearly see that the range where the engraving effect is the strongest is much shallower. Next, I leveraged the Omni's full 10 watts of power to perform a deep engraving on stone. I ran the machine for just 15 passes at 60 kHz with a 1 nanosecond pulse at the speed of 500 millimeters per second. The engraving was completed quickly, and for comparison, I ran the same design with just one pass beside it. The ComMarker Omni delivered a deep and crisp result. Honestly, it couldn't be better. I'm extremely satisfied with it. I also wanted to test how the 10W model performs on glass. UV lasers use UV light for live previews, which are the sharpest and most precise of any laser type, though visibility can be limited on certain materials. To assist with rough alignment, the machine includes a preview acrylic sheet. For more precise positioning, I use thin yellow post-it notes, which work very well. One of my subscribers suggested another great solution: luminous powder that glows when activated by UV light. Just apply a thin layer with a soft brush and you'll get a clear preview. I'll leave a link to the powder in the video description if you want to try it yourself. Once positioned, I started the engraving. The higher power of the 10W laser made the process significantly faster and more reliable than with the 5W version. The result was flawless. UV laser like the ComMarker Omni is the best tool for making incredibly precise engravings on glass. For fun, I switched to the 70mm lens, which has a much shallower depth of field and much stronger engraving power. I focused the machine inside the middle of the glass metal to see if I can make an embedded engraving inside the material. I placed the glass on a piece of stone which wouldn't stain the bottom surface if the beam would pass through the glass. The engraving worked like a charm. I ran a few passes to get a high contrast engraving. The result is a completely embedded engraving inside the glass with an untouched smooth surface on both sides. It looks incredible. Looking under a microscope, we can see that an incredible level of detail can be achieved this way. Extra power is also beneficial when engraving curved objects, such as wine glasses and cylindrical surfaces, where not all areas are in perfect focus. Out-of-focus beams require more power to effectively engrave tougher materials like glass. Once again, the ComMarker Omni delivered excellent results. The results are much more detailed compared to sandblasting or engraving with a CO2 laser. I also had a small side job where I needed to engrave 60 special glasses for liquor. Using the ComMarker flexible fixture, it was quick and easy to make a simple but very sturdy jig, which held these weirdly shaped glasses on the correct position for engraving. Engraving with the ComMarker is fast, and thanks to the foot pedal, you can engrave a whole batch in very short amount of time. This machine can pay itself off very quickly. I then tested how well the UV laser could engrave and cut aluminum business cards. I engraved a highly detailed design to assess how well the details held up. The machine cut through a 0.4 millimeter aluminum card in just a few passes with razor-sharp precision. I repeated the engraving on a thinner black card just to see the possible differences. The cutout is razor thin and very clean. Despite their small size, the cards look amazing. If we look at them under the microscope, we can see the true level of detail that a UV laser can achieve even with this larger area lens. I also performed a deep engraving on raw aluminum using 20 passes at a relatively high speed of 500 millimeters per second. For deep engraving, I used 50 kHz and 1 nanosecond pulse, and at the end I ran a cleaning pass with double the speed at 100 kHz and a 5 nanosecond pulse. The result was stunning, clean, sharp, and with impressive depth. After learning that the 10W UV laser can ablate metal with ease, I tested its ability to etch a PCB. It completed the job in just 6 cutting passes and 2 cleaning passes, all within a few minutes. The result was extremely clean, with no charring like you might see with fiber lasers. I believe that with more passes it could even handle cutouts and holes. If you're torn between a UV laser and a fiber laser, I recommend watching my comparison video linked in the video description. Next, I tested various engraving effects on stainless steel using the 10W ComMarker Omni. I tried different speeds and achieved a range of finishes, from light brown to polished finish and white marks. However, I was unable to produce a black annealing effect like it is possible to do with fiber lasers. I also engraved a photo with and without a background pass. The result came out quite well, but adjusting the settings a bit would help significantly. Naturally, the 10W version also produces excellent engravings on plastic. The plastic is where UV lasers really shine. I highly recommend checking out my review of the 5W ComMarker Omni, where I tested many other materials, all of which also apply to this upgraded machine. I will leave a link in the video description. In conclusion, the 10W ComMarker Omni is the better choice if you want to engrave faster, achieve deeper engraving effects, or work with more challenging materials like wine glasses or surfaces that are typically difficult to engrave or cut. However, if your primary focus is engraving plastics or similar materials, and you don't require the extra speed or power, the 5W version will serve you perfectly well.